Okay, let's start the class. Okay, we can't wait. So let's start the class. I'm sharing my screen. So we'll continue with the depreciation. And let them know from section A students that I won't repeat this class. Okay, so basically in the last class we studied about what is depreciation, what are the causes of depreciation, and we studied about straight line method and declining balance method, right? So we saw two numericals from the straight line method. Any doubts from straight line method? Any doubts? Those who are present in the class, any doubts from the this straight line method? Hope these two numericals are clear. Okay, go through these numericals. In the final exams, you will get numericals. In 4 marks questions, you will get a lot of numericals. So go through all the numericals I have discussed in the class. Next is declining balance method. We assume here a fixed percentage of book value to of previous book value to find out the depreciation. This. So depreciation for the 6th year D6 will be that constant percentage into book value of the previous year, that is B5. Okay, and now you can find the book value again. Suppose you need to find the book value for 6th year, that will be equal to book value of the 5th year minus depreciation of the 6th year. Or in the simple way, you can also use this formula BT equals to 1 minus K BT minus 1. So these are the general formula, but suppose you don't have a B value, instant previous B value, and you have K, so you can also use K 1 minus K T minus 1 into P. And for book value, you can use 1 minus K to the power T into P. If this K, this capital K, is equal to twice of twice by N, if you divide, if you get this K twice by N, then it is called a double declining balance method. Or you can say if this N into K is K is twice of, or you can say N is twice of 2K. If number of years is twice of 2K, then it will be called as double declining balance method. So this was the numerical problem number one. Glaxo company has purchased a machine for rupees 150,000. This will be your P value. The plant engineer estimates that it estimates that the machine has a useful life of 10 years and a salvage value of rupees 25,000 at the end of the useful life. So your F is 25,000. Then demonstrate the calculation of the declining balance method of depreciation by assuming 0.2 for K. So your K value is 0.2. The constant percentage is 0.2. Now using the formula, they have asked you to find out the depreciation for various year. N is your 10 years. Okay. Demonstrate the calculation of the declining balance method of depreciation by assuming 0.24. So these are the given with this formula: DT is equal to K into BT minus 1, BT equals to BT minus 1 minus DT. By using this formula, you can find out the various depreciation and book value. So for the 1st year, your depreciation will be 150,000, and in the same way, if you divide it. By using this formula for depreciation, if you see here in the straight line method, depreciation were same. Why same? Because we assume there that depreciation is a fixed amount. If you let's go back to definition of straight line. depreciation of fixed sum is charged as depreciation. So a fixed sum was charged as depreciation. That's why depreciation was constant in straight line method. But in balance decline method, depreciation is not constant. So you have to find. Okay. So it will be K into BT minus 1. And K is your... Sorry. So K is your 0.2. And B is the book value of the previous value. So if you see this problem... If you see, for the first year, your depreciation will be 0 and the book value will be 1,50,000. To find out the depreciation for the first year, so what is the formula basically? Find out the depreciation, K into B, T minus 1. So, depreciation is DT is equal to K into B, T minus 1, right? So, to find out a depreciation for first year, that is D1 equals to K is your 0.2 into BT minus 1. That means T is 1. So, 1 minus 1 will be 0. So, B0 is your 1,50,000. So, 1,50,000. So, if you do 0.2 into 1,50,000, you will get 30,000. As depreciation. This is for first year. Okay. Now move to the second year. Let's move to the second year. Let's move to the second year. So to find out the depreciation for the second year, it will be 0.2 into B 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 will be B1, right? Let me add, students are coming. Let me add, okay. So for D2, it will be 0.2 into B1. Got it or not? Depreciation formula is DT equals to K BT minus 1. So T is your 2. K will be 0.2 into 2 minus 1 is B1. So what is your B1? B1 is your 1,20,000. So if you do 0.2 into 1,20,000, you will get 24,000. That is your depreciation at the end of 2 years. So likewise, find out, you have to find out the depreciation as the number of years is 10. You have to find out the depreciation till the 10th year. Okay, understood? Any doubt? Quickly, if you have doubt, then say if you don't doubt.
No, ma'am.
Oh, okay. Someone is texting me that today is holiday. Okay. Roll number 25. Is this Rohit? See, as I told yesterday, I have told many times that I'll take some extra classes. Okay. So this is one of those extra classes and you'll get attendance for this also. Don't worry about this. Oh, this class will be recorded and this class will be updated in the ARP. This class will be updated in YouTube. So let them others know. If you just take out a one hour class, that won't be any issue, I guess. Okay, Rohit. I think Rohit has texted me. Rohit 25 roll number texted me. I think Rohit it is. So though from section A, let them others know from section A. That I am taking this class will be recorded, attendance will be given, everything will be given and I won't repeat this class. Okay. Already I informed that I'll take some extra classes, so you should know na. I know this is a holiday. Let me pause this record. Okay. So calculate the depreciation and book value for the period of 5. Now, in this question, they have directly asked you to find out the depreciation and book value for the period of 5 using the declining balance method. By assuming 0.2 for K and rupees 1,20,000 for P and salvage value of rupees 10,000, the useful life of the machinery is 10 years. So, P is 1,20,000, your salvage value is 10,000, N is simply 10 years and K is 0.2. So they directly ask you to find out the book value and depreciation for 5. So what you can do, you can directly use this formula now, because see, in previous formula it was to find out the depreciation you need the book previous book value, right? K into B T minus 1. But you now in this case you didn't have the previous book value. They directly ask you to find out the book value for sixth year. So to find out the book value for sixth year, to find out the depreciation for sixth year, you should have the book value for the fifth year. You don't have that value. In that case, what you can do, we can use these two formula. Okay, you have K value, you have P value. Then you can apply in place of T, you can replace this with T will be replaced with 6. Oh, they have asked me for 5th year, right? Yes. So, see this formula. K is 0.2. 1 minus 0.2. T minus 1. So, T is your 5 minus 1 into 120,000. So, this is the depreciation for the 5th year. And in the same way, you can find the book value for the 5th year. 1 minus K to the power T into P. So, this is the book value for the 5th year. Very simple questions. Just you have to know P. You have to take out the P, F, N, and T. Okay. Now let's move to the next topic. That is sum of years digits method. The scrap value of the asset is deducted from its original value. See, now students are coming. This proves. Let's continue. The scrap value of the asset is deducted from its original cost, and it is assumed that the book value of the asset decreases at a decreasing rate. So what we do, scrap value, that the value you get from the scrap value, you can consider when you demolished a house, there will be some useful material, okay, like crushed bricks, some frames you can sell. So these are the money you get by selling those scrap items is a scrap value. So what they do, they used to deduct that scrap value of the asset is deducted from its original cost. So if P is the original cost, scrap value is deducted from the original cost, and it is assumed that just give me a minute. Okay. So, and it is assumed that the book value of the asset decreases at a decreasing rate. So now the book value, that book value of the asset decreasing at a decreasing rate. So now there is a one formula, sum of the years, n plus 1 by 2. Now to find out the depreciation, there will be a decrease in the rate of asset into P minus F, and you can find the book value BT minus 1 minus DT. The formula for DT and BT for a specific year T are as follows. So this is these two formulas you can use to find out the depreciation and book value at the end of each year, and this DT and BT you can find out for a specific year. Now this sum of years n plus 1 by 2 is they have replaced this. This is the sum of the years. This is the sum of years. Just remember this formula. The rest is easy. So let's see a numerical. ABC company has purchased an equipment whose first cost is rupees 2 lakh with an estimated life of 8 years. So P is your 2 lakh, N is 8 years. Estimated scrap value of the equipment at the end of lifetime is 40,000, that is F. Determine the depreciation charge and book value at the end of various years using this method. In this method also, your P is 2 lakh, F is 40,000, N is 8 years, and sum of years you can find N plus 1, N is 8, n plus 1 will be 9, so 8 into 9 by 2. So this is this way you can find out the depreciation and book value. So the for the first year your book value will be 2 lakh. Now for the second year your depreciation has reached to 35,555. How? This is by using P minus F into the rate. In this way, if you see in this formula, in this method, your book value at the end of the life and your salvage value is same. Okay, now they if in this numerical they have asked you to find out the they have asked you to find out the rate for a particular year. So using this formula, you just replace this T with the year given to you. So if they have asked you for the fifth year, so just replace this T with 5. In this way, you will get the depreciation for the fifth year 17,777, and a book value for the fifth year is 66 lakhs. Oh, this is 17 lakh 777. 66 lakh 666. Now sinking fund method. In this method of depreciation, a depreciation fund equal to the actual loss in the value of the asset is estimated for each year. So what you do, the amount which is getting depreciated every year from the actual cost, you estimate. Suppose you have purchased the mobile phone for 15,000 rupees, and every year it is the value of that product is decreasing like 500 rupees. So you are estimating that, and that amount is invest outside the business in a separate account that is called a sinking fund investment. And interest will be earned on that fund. So what you are doing, you have purchased a mobile phone for 15,000, and you know that it is getting depreciated as amount of rupees 500 every year. Now what you are doing, you are saving that money in some account and you are getting interest on that. So that is your sinking fund. The sinking fund will rise year after year. So when you save that money and you earn that interest at the end of the life of that asset, your money will be equal to the actual cost of your product, actual cost of the phone. Okay, and that extra money is your sinking fund. So in this, P is the first cost of the asset, F is the salvage value of the asset, N is life of the asset, I is the rate of return, A is the annual equivalent amount, B is the book value, D is the depreciation. Now the loss of value of the asset is made available in the form of cumulative depreciation amount. So P minus F, A by F, I into N. So last class we discussed, we can write this A by F, I, N is in this formula. Right? This will be 1 plus I to the power n minus 1 divided by I 1 plus I to the power n, right? So this will be the formula. P minus F multiplied by 1 plus I to the power n minus 1 I in bracket 1 plus I in bracket close to the power n. Okay. The fixed sum depreciated at the end of every time period earns an interest at the rate of I compound annually. So to find out the depreciation, P minus F in the bracket A by F I n and P by F by P I T minus 1. So here n will be the number of year life of the assets, t minus 1 will be for the for which year they have asked you to find out the. So just in the place of n you can just replace the t minus 1. That means for which year they have asked you to find out the depreciation or book value. So there is a simple numerical given. Find the depreciation annuity by annuity method after 3 years. So n is here 3 years when the initial cost was 8 lakh, and the salvage value at the end of 3 years is 4 lakh. Rate of interest is 10 years. So P is given, F is given, I is given. N is 3 years, I is 10%. So you can find the annual equity with the help of this formula. P minus F, 8 lakh minus 4,000, A by F, I to the power N. So this is nothing but, you can use the same formula, 1 plus I is 10%, divide by I is 10, again 10%, 1 plus, or this will be 10%. Let me add out. So 1 plus, write in the digit form, okay, 10%, write in the digit form. So I have just wrote it, 10%, 1 plus I, again 10%, to the power, this will be to the power n is 3, minus 1, to the power 3. So in this way, if you solve this, you will get 0.3021. So just multiply it. This is your annually depreciation amount. So to find out the DT and BT, you can use this formula. So DT is P minus F. Again, A by F, I, N, and P by F by P, I, T minus 1. So for the first year, your fixed DT is 1,20,840 rupees, and the book value will be 8 lakh. Now this fixed DT is will be same for the all the three four years sorry all the 3 years. Just you have to find out the net depreciation. So for the first year, this will be the same depreciation. Now for the second year, the depreciation will be this plus the same depreciation into 0.1, 10% at because a rate of rate of depreciation depreciation was just give me a minute. Yes, I you can find the depreciation for the first year plus depreciation into for rate of interest, which is 0.10. So this is the rate of depreciation for the second year. Now for the depreciation for the third year, this plus this value, you will get the depreciation for the third year. And the same way you can find out the book value. Okay, try it by yourself. If you don't understand, we'll discuss again in the next class. Again, one more problem is given. P, F, N, I, everything is given. Then they have asked you to find out the depreciation for the 6th and 7th year at a rate of interest 12%. So, same way, A by F, 12% of 8. The same formula I have discussed, right? 1 plus I to the power N minus 1 divided by I, 1 plus I to the power N. By that, they have got 0.0813. For this, they have got 1.7622. So just multiplied it, they got the depreciation. Now for the book value, again, they have used this formula P minus F. Again, A by F, I, N, and P by F by P, I, T. So they have used the same P minus F. A by F, 12% of 8. F by F, 12% of 7. 12% of 7. Yes. So they got this. By solving this one, they got this. By solving this one, they got this. And this is your book value. So don't get confused with these terms, right? I have given a formula. That is, this is the shortest way to write it in like this. OK. Just remember the formula. I am again explaining the again explaining this expression. So this will be 1 plus 12% to the power I is 5. So n will be 5 divided by I is 12%. Write the 12% in digits. Okay, it will take me a lot of space. That's why I'm writing 12%. 1 plus again 12% to the power 5. This is minus 1. Okay, so this is this f by p is nothing but this. If you solve this, you will get 1.762. In place of n, in place of 5, here you can place 8. So you will get this value. In here, same 12% and 8, 12% and 7. So just in this way, you just have to use the main formula is 1 plus I to the power n minus 1 whole divided by I bracket 1 plus I to the power n. Okay. So in this way, you can find these values. Now service output. Last method. Okay, no, we have one more method, evaluation of public alternatives. Okay, so let's discuss this quickly. The service, in service output method, in this method, the machine is expressed in terms of number of units that a machine is expected to produce over the estimated life. So based on how much service it can give, we can find out the depreciation. Here, PV is the first cost of the asset, F is the salvage value, X is the maximum capacity of service of the asset during its lifetime, and X is the quantity of service rendered in a period. So, capital is the capacity, how much service it can give, maximum capacity, and small x is the quantity it had produced during its period. Now, depreciation per unit of service is P minus F divided by capital X. And depreciation for X unit of service period is P minus F divided by capital F just multiplied with, this is per unit service and this is for X quantity. Okay, this is the per unit. For one unit, this is the service. For X number of units, this will be just multiplication of X. So see, if you see the numerical, P is given, F is given, capital X is given, small x is given. So just they have asked you to find out the depreciation for third year. So simply to find out the depreciation for the third year, depreciation of X unit of service in 3 year, P minus F capital X and 1500. So it is given also in its third year of operation, the length of the road laid is 15 kilometers. So small x is given. On third year, it is 1500. So just you have to, this rest is the same. P, F, capital X is same.
Ma'am.
How
do we know that it's capital X and small x from the question?
Okay.
How do we find that?
So see, just let's read the question. The first cost of a road laying machine is rupees 60,000. So this is, this you can know, right? This is capital P. The first cost of a road laying machine is, first you have purchased the machine, so that is your P value. And it is clearly mentioned its salvage value after 5 years of service is 40,000. So this is your F. Now about X. The length of the road that can be laid by that machine during the lifetime is 55,000 kilometers. So what is X? Is maximum capacity of service of the asset during its lifetime. So it is said that the length of the road that can be laid by that machine during whole lifetime is 55,000. So capital X is 50,000. What is capital X? How much service it can give during its lifetime. So it is this is clear by this line. Thus this can be from this machine you can lay the road till 55,000 kilometers. So this, that is capital X. Clear? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now in its third year of operation, the length of the road is okay. Now small x. Small x is quantity of service rendered in a period, any period. So it is already said that in third year it can lay the length of road as 1500 kilometer. and you have been asked to find out the depreciation for that year. So this is small x. This is the quantity of service rendered in a period. So in x, in third year, it can give you 1500. So it is a small x. Now clear? Now clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next is evaluation of public alternatives. So basically this one, if you have two or more alternatives, what will be the more important factor of choosing that alternative? Okay, it is the selection of best alternative from the available alternatives. The factor considered in selection is profit maximization. Obviously, the alternative which will give us more and more profit will choose those alternatives. Now there is one more term. BC ratio is given. This is if you find out the BC ratio, you can consider a BC ratio factor also in choosing an alternative in front of you. What is BC ratio basically? Equivalent benefits divided by equivalent cost. So how much you are invest? Suppose in an area you have to provide an irrigation system. So you have estimated that this much will be the cost of setting up an irrigation channel, but after that you also have to analyze that how much is the benefit you are getting from that. If this BC ratio is not maintained, if you are not getting much benefits, what is the purpose of investing so much of money? So you have that there should be a proportionate between the benefit and investment. Okay, so you can find out the BC ratio with the help of these. This formula BP divided by P plus CP, or BF divided by PF plus CF, or BA divided by PA plus C. Now what is BP? Present worth of total benefits. BF is the future worth of total benefits. And A is the annual equivalent of total benefits. So present, future and annual. Same way, CP is the present worth of yearly cost of operation and maintenance. CF is the future worth of yearly cost of operation and maintenance. And PA is the investment, future investment. P, simple P is the initial investment, and C is the early cost of operation and maintenance. So these are the notations. And these are the formulas to find out the BC ratio. So one numerical is given. There are two projects considered for investment. Project A1 requires an initial investment. Okay, let's see the given from alternative 1. For alternative 1, P is given, B is given, N is given, I is given. So you can find out the BC ratio. You can use either formula. They have used annual equivalent benefits and annual equivalent cost. That means BA by PA plus C. So for annual equivalent of initial cost will be C A minus P 10% of pi. So I know, I think now you can solve this part. Now P is for 40 lakh. So just you multiply with this. So this will be the annual equivalent of initial cost. So that means your P plus C. Okay, initial investment plus this. And BA is your. Okay, ma'am, please show the question properly. Okay, see the question. Okay. Project A1 and project A2 are being considered for investment. A1 requires an initial investment of 40 lakh. Okay, it's 4 lakh, I think. Yes, it's 4 lakh, and net recipients estimated as 10 lakh per year for the next 5 years. The initial overlay for the A2 is 70 lakh, and the net recipients have been estimated of 16 lakh per year for the next 7 years. There is no salvage value associated with either of the project. Using the benefit to cost ratio, which project would you select? And interest rate is 10%. So clear the question. Now P is 40. Somewhere they wrote 4 lakh. Somewhere they wrote it's 40 lakh. Make the correction in the question, okay? So P is your 40 lakh. B is given. That is your you can say annual equivalent of total benefits is your 10 lakh per year. So B is 10 lakh. And N is 5 years. So to find out the BC ratio based on annual equivalent cost and annual equivalent benefits. So annual equivalent benefits is given in the question, which is 10 lakh. Now you need to find annual equivalent cost. You can find with the help of this P. A by P, the rate is 10% and N is 5 years. So by using this formula, annual equivalent of initial cost is your 10,55,200. Now the BC ratio is 0.9475. Now let's move to the alternative 2. P was 70 lakh, B was 15 lakh, N was 7 years, I is 10. Please give me a second. Okay, why we have selected annual? Because they have given us net receipt per year. So they have given the annual this value, annual benefit. They have given us the value in annual terms. That's why we have used the annual benefit and annual investment. So this is the annual equivalent benefits we have calculated. Sorry, we have been given this is the benefited and we have calculated the cost. In the same way, benefit is given as 15 lakh. Now equivalent cost is P, A by P, 10% of 7. So this is the equivalent cost divided, you got the BC ratio. Now if you compare the BC ratio of both the alternatives, alternative 2 has more BC ratio. So the benefit cost ratio of alternative 2 is more than the alternative 1, hence alternative 2 is selected. So the alternative which have more BC ratio, that means it will have more benefit. More BC ratio means it will have more benefit comparison to the cost. So we'll select that alternative. So that's all for today's class. Understood? Okay, those who came to the class, you can write your roll numbers because this chat will end in 5 minutes. So all of you write your roll numbers. Okay, those who wrote their roll number, they can leave. Yeah, I'm sharing all the notes to by today itself in the group. Okay, thank you. Ending the meeting, I have taken out, I have note down all the roll numbers. I'll share the notes positively today. Okay, thank you.